And today, it's our great privilege to have Mr. Mohammed Alohaly. Mr. Mohammed Alohaly, صراحةً, and I know like how I got to know him, that I had one student, she told me, Mr. Mohammed is helping me to start my business. And I said, oh my God, and like, what I heard about him, really his experience, like helping students, and people starting businesses, and mashallah, he started, you know, like food of these businesses. Then I thought we need to invite him. I said it will be our honor to invite him. Mr. Mohammed Alohaly, as I sent you in the email and the flyer, you can see the flyer here. He is the general manager at IUC. It's one of Fawaz Al-Hikir Group. I think they have like some brands, Cinnabon, Seattle Best Coffee, and all of these brands. They have them there, and he manages. He's the founder of Shawarma Plus, Pizzaratti, and CEO of Jam Burger from 2014-2016. And he has, mashallah, a lot of 20 years of experience in marketing and sales. And actually, you can check his Twitter account. You know, when I went to his Twitter, mashallah, he has around like 10,000 followers, and he has a lot of good stuff about the branding and marketing and so on. So with that, let's go ahead and give a big welcome for our guest, Mr. Mohammed. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you for giving me this beautiful introduction. And thank you for being here, giving me your precious time. I'll start with the title. Start marketing before even you start, you know, before even you start your business. How does this work? Give me your thoughts. I mean, this thing, what you hear. Do you have a mic that you can share with the... I mean, you can shout. It's a very small area. Who has an idea? How can you start marketing before you start your business? Give me just general thoughts.
Listen. Social media.
So, but how? So, shall I start doing social media before I start my business?
Networking.
How does this work? I mean, if you're going to sell bags, am I going to put the bags before I start my business? So where's the bag? How are you going to buy?
Talk about it. Research.
Okay, good.
Research.
Who has a marketing or business background here? Raise your hands, please. No marketing, business background? So you're competing in the marketing and business field, but you're not marketeers. So those people make money. Us who study, we don't make money.
Yes,
sir. Excellent, guys. What's the definition of marketing? What do you know about marketing? Most of the people think marketing is social media, advertisement. Is that the perception you have about marketing? Or do you know something else about marketing? What do you know else about marketing, guys?
Branding,
excellent. Part of the very important aspect of marketing. What else? No idea about marketing? You follow Total Amora, Haneen, Ashreen, Ashreen, or Yabu Shahian. Those are the only things you know about marketing. Yeah, a lot of people think social media is the only thing of marketing. The definition I like about marketing is it's an art and a science of understanding people's needs and satisfying them with a product or service, right place, right time, right price. So what is marketing? Is it an art only? You find a lot of artistic people that do good visuals. I know a company that starts with the letter Zain. But there's a company that starts with the letter Zain. They do very excellent videos. But they're losing money. They're losing billions. They're losing 2.7 billion Saudi riyal till now. And they have the best advertisement ever. Very creative. Ogilvy once said, and please write this as a title for anyone that wants to do advertisement. I don't care how much creative your ad is. What I care about, how much does it sell? So you find a lot of creative videos. Zain, which I mentioned, they have the best videos ever. Sometimes I cry on their advertisements. It's very nice, but they're losing money. They're not selling because it's not about creativity in the ad. It's about, does it move you to buy the product? And this is the secret and the beauty of marketing. So it's not only an art, it's a science. And this is where you need to start marketing before you start your business. by understanding the market. So marketing is, we mentioned, is understanding the people's needs. How do I know people's needs? Do I go to a company like AC Nielsen, I pay them 2, 3, 4, 5 million? I don't think most of us here can afford paying a research company that amount of money to start a product or a service. So how can I know that there's a need of everything that I would produce or bring? كيف أعرف إنه في حاجة للمنتج أو الخدمة اللي أنا بسويها قبل لا أبدأ؟ How do I know that? Girls, you're gonna bring a product now. You're here because you wanna sell something. You wanna open your own business. How do you know that people need it? How do you know that people will buy that product? Tell me.
Research.
Part of the research is what?
Survey.
Maybe surveys. But the people reply for surveys. يعني, what's your product? Give me any future product you wanna bring. نظارات أنا وياك نظارات. Okay. How do I know that لو برسل على الناس يعني surveys please reply do you need one more يعني محل نظارات زيادة في الاريا maybe most of them wouldn't reply so my key advice for you which most of the companies that I've started with is a need a complaint a problem we're problem solvers the doctor is not there if you are not a patient so we are problem solvers. We solve problems. So I take your problem and I bring something to solve that problem. So every one of you, if you are complaining about the coiffeur in the corner burning your hair, so that's an issue. Most of the area is complaining about the coiffeur or salon you موجود في الزاوية. الحلاق لو انت كل يوم شكلك طالع بشكل مو كويس او قاعد تعاني, you're waiting for a queue for 2 and 3 or 4 hours to shave your beard or to get a shave for your head. That's an issue that you need to start with. So this is the start of starting marketing before your business is understanding those needs, understanding those pains. How many pains is there in the area? That's a good start to start with before paying money for research companies. So start with those pains. If you wanted to grab a coffee and you wait or you go half an hour driving for your best coffee shop, that's an issue. A coffee shop should be within 2 to 3 minutes from my home. So that's a good start for you, is maybe our area needs a coffee shop. So the second question after I know that there's a need for a coffee shop, how big is that market? If I said we need a coiffeur or a salon in the corner, how many females do we have in our area? You know what's the easiest thing I do before I did Shawarma Plus? AC Nielsen asked me to pay 900,000. You know what did I do before I started the shawarma business? I stopped in front of all the shawarma places I want to open in. So there were 6 shawarma places in the block. Every day I stay in one shawarma place. And I grab a pen. Okay? بعد إن مزهقت حطيت كاميرا جو برو. صرت أسرع الشريط وأقول للسكرتير خلي بندق. فدخل هنا 500 دخل هنا 400 دخل هنا 1000 طب عرفنا ان اللي شرى شاورما اليوم approximately 2 to 3,000 طب 2 to 3,000 is it enough if I'm gonna bring another shawarma concept will it be compatible would it be feasible مربحه ولا لا so I divided the number of 3,000 على 6 محلات بس ما قلت انه انا حاخذ بالضبط لان شاورما اقوى مني Mama Noura, أقوى مني. They have their names. So I said, if I grab only 5% of that market, so I had 3,000 client, and I said, if I only took 5% of that market, من كويس في الدنيا 3,000 كم 5% من 1,000 كم business 5% من لا 50% من 1,000 لا 5% 50 من الألف فأنا عندي 150 كلاينت طب مربحين ولا لا؟ كيف أعرف إنهم مربحين ولا لا؟ أخذ الأفريج تشيك كيف أعرف الأفريج تشيك؟ أدخل جوا وأسمع كل الفواتير هذا طلب ب 80 ريال هذا طلب ب 1000 هذا طلب ب 50 أخذت الأفريج متوسط طلباتهم ب 70 ريال فضربت 150 ضرب 70 واو that's a profitable business for me. This is above my pay grade. ولد فات ليس نفسه مليون ولا مليونين ولا تعرف. It was this simple. Sometimes you need to utilize your tools. احنا small businessmen يعني ما عندنا المليونز اللي موجودة عند الشركات الكبيرة. If we talk about our level of investing, we need to do this kind of small research. Very easy, very simple. رحنا الصالون، كم واحدة دخلت على الصالون؟ صالون نورة اليوم دخلوا 100 عميلة. مو لازم نجلس في صالون نورة، مو لازم ننام فيه اليوم كله. لا، ممكن أقيس على ساعة معينة. I can count on a certain hour. في الساعة A دخلوا 50 client. بعدين أجي بالليل في الساعة B لو غلش hour دخلوا 200. فأطلع average per hour كم ساعة تفتح صالون نورة وغرب. بعدين أطلع الأفرج خلود سوى شعره 500 هذه 300 هذه 200 الأفرج وضع 300 I multiply it and I do the math. Okay, open here. في دخلوا على الصالون في هذه الأريا في 600 أنثى. ف there is a place if I took only 5% it will be important. متى أقول لك لا تفتح هنا؟ إذا 5% was less than your break even. Break even أنا إيجاري زاد عمالي زاد كذا باليوم لازم 1000 ريال. وال 5% ما يعطون الا 400 ريال. انا This is not right. So this is a good start. Do you think it's a useful tool? You can use it. تبدون تلاحظون بكره كم عميل دخل توسط فور.
So this is the behavior study.
This is helping you to build a visibility study. This is helping you only to say okay, there's a market for shawarma. This is number one. So we now know the product. There's a market for يعني a salon. There's a market now for opticals in this area. So this is a good start. I know that there is a need, there's a problem. I need to wash my car, there's no place to wash my car. And this is a pain for 20 of my friends in the area. Is 20 enough? Do the math. This is the minimum.
If there is like compatible.
Of course. إذا ما خد 5% معناته you are a disaster. Because once you start, you have a good product. Of course, you're not going to bring a product or a service which is not good. So this is the minimum in the honeymoon phase, the people that's going to come to you. Because in the honeymoon phase, which we call the honeymoon phase, we try new things. والله مطعم فتح جنبنا خلنا نجرب. So if you did not catch me in the honeymoon, you have an issue. You have a problem with your product. And now we're going to reach to this point is after you bring that product, you do a test, and after the testing, you put a label on it. Because most of the girls, once they come, I used to operate منشآت. I used to operate for 1 year and a half. كنت ماسك تشغيل مركز الإرشاد لسنة ونص في منشآت. Most of the pain that came from especially the females is I used to produce a very nice product, cake, salad, whatever. My mom, my dad, my neighbors were saying it's a marvelous product. But once I opened my business, no one bought from me. I said, of course, because I'm your mom and dad. That's number one. So number two is putting a price label on it and trying to sell it. If your cousin said, wow, your cake is marvelous. Okay, Gurina, my cake is 300 riyal. You want in your next event, you want me to prepare something for you. They said, tell me, no, wait. It's for free, and you're giving it to her. It's going to be some of this product. So try putting a label, a price label on it, and sell it to a small market to know is your product compatible or not before you go ahead and open your business. So this is for a start, is understanding the pain. This is how you start marketing before you start your businesses by knowing the gaps, knowing the problems. This is number one. Number two is knowing your market. We said there's a shawarma, but don't you see now shawarmas are selling for 15 riyal and other places are selling for 4 riyal? Isn't it a market of shawarma? But how can I say it? How do I know? How to justify this? So I bought a product, we know there's a pain for shawarma or a product for, you know, a coffee. But this guy is selling his coffee for 20 riyal and there's Qahwat Derby sells the coffee for 4 riyal. It's a chaos on the highways, if you know. They sell the coffee for 4 riyal. Which one am I in? There's a rule for that. Porter has a strategy which is a very nice strategy, which I like to divide the markets on. Do you think we can sell, say before I go to the strategy, Do you think we can sell the same product for three different prices?
Yes.
No.
And all you know about the different price and you are happy? أنا لو شاري سيارة بمليون هل ممكن نعرف إن أخوي شراها ب 400,000 وأنا مبسوط عادي؟
لا.
Okay. How does this work in market? Porter divided and there are products in the market. Rolex they have Tudor. It's exactly the same car, watch. Rolex they sell it for minimum 40,000 riyal. Tudor 10,000 riyal. And once you go and buy a Rolex, you know that Tudor is exactly the same product from the same factory that owned by Rolex, but they sell for 10,000 riyal. And you are happy. You don't wear it anymore. I wear Rolex because they played on what? The value of the gold, of the brand itself. Same product. So exactly for the guys, and even you drive now. Usually I say this to guys only. Bentley, Volkswagen Vuitton, and the Audi A8 is exactly the same car. Bentley is 1.2 million riyal. Audi A8 is 600,000 riyal. The Vuitton was 420. It's a special Vuitton from Volkswagen. It's a special car. They don't produce it. So exactly the same car from the same factory. Same spare parts. 1.2 million. Well, this one is 400,000. And I know that this guy bought the Vuitton from the surgeon, and I'm happy I bought a Bentley. Because he's talking to a different target audience. He's not talking to the same guy. Once you go to the website of Volkswagen, it's totally different than Bentley. Is it the same guys? Salesman is different. Showroom is different. So they're playing on other things rather than only the product. They understand which market they are in. So Vargo divided the markets to three markets. They said niche, like a Rolls Royce. There's a niche market, small number of people, but with a high volume, high margin. But this market is very picky. I mean, a Rolls Royce is very sensitive. You don't go into a Rolls Royce and you give him the low expect more fair. He expects a Vian. Yeah, wallah, he has a low respect for what I worked in the Rajah. But this is his expectation. If you go to another different place, your expectation is different. So the markets are three markets in any business you know, Abayat, Sawaleem, whatever. The perfect model I like to divide markets in is three. Niche market, very small with high margin, but this is a very sensitive market. Be careful dealing with those people. تقول أنا قهوة 5-star, you need to be a coffee 5-star. ما أجي البرستا عندك والقاه he's not clean, he's not there, he doesn't know about the coffee. برستا في كوفي يبيع القهوة بخمسين وستين ريال the cup. He needs to know each and every small detail about the coffee. وين مزروع أو في أي وقت وبعد التحميص وال so you satisfy the client اللي جاي شاري من عندك لأن his expectation is really high. ما أجي واللي موظف هو نفسه موظف في كوفي يشتغل في براندات يتعامل مع cost leader. So we have niche market, we have a cost leader, and we have a product differentiation. If we're gonna go to the car market, we can say Chinese cars. Cost leader, differentiation, a Mercedes and a BMW, they are a different car. Niche market, it's a Rolls Royce. We can apply this to watches. We can say Swatch, Rolex, and we can say Patek, Jacob & Co, whatever, you know, you can call other names. But if you go to the showrooms of Swatch and Patek, it's not the same showroom. Salesman is different. So once you know this, where are you gonna, if your product was Shawarma, Salon, Abayat, whatever, ask yourself, أنا بكون niche market, بتعامل مع 50 بنت, بتعامل مع 50 رجال. Okay, those are my market. وإنف مع margin مرة عالي. ولا لا, أنا بروح cost leader, بنزل السعر, ببيع عبايات 150 ريال, 100 ريال, بس ببيع غوري معي. أنا أقدر أبيع 10,000 عباية. أقدر. أو أروح differentiation لا عندي عبايات بس أنا ماني مرة نيش مو بعبايات خيوط ذهب والعباية بعشرين ثلاثين ألف لا أروح شوي differentiation العباية بألف ألف خمسمية ألفين القهوة محل الرياضة whatever you wanna call it so this triangle is applicable for any kind of business in the world. Niche and what? Ashatani Andra?
Cost
leader.
Cost
leader, what? Differentiation. طبقها على أي شيء في حياتك. محل كوفي تبغاه، يعني سيارات تبغاه، اللي تبغاه. It will work. اللي تنتبه منه ايش؟ Being stuck in the middle. نقطة خطيرة جدا. They call it Icarus contrast. They call it تناقض Icarus. تناقض Icarus وحشى لله ولله المثل الأعلى. لكن هي مش عند اليونانيين يقول لك Icarus كان إله في الأرض. حشى لله تعالى الله. ولكن هي مثل درس عندنا في المستقبل. يقول لك كان إله في الأرض مبسوط. بعدين ناور السمكة ليش أنا أقول إله السمكة؟ ركب أجنحة وطار. لابد أجنحته مع الشمس طاح الراس ومات. But this is what happens in business لما ما تفهم أنت وين هذا التراينجل. لما تيجي تخبص وتدخل أشياء حقت كوست ليدر في أشياء نيش ماركت. يعني أنا أسأل واحدة من الأخوات تقول لي أنا الكيكة عندي كانت تسوي كب كيك. It was 13 ريال. I said, why 13 ريال? I can go to Munch and take it for 6 ريال. She said, my cake is different. But no one bought from her. But why is your cake different? How can your cake be a niche market? Tell me, guys, girls, how can your cake be a niche market? هي تبي تروح على سعر 13. تبي تبيع الكيكة 13. تقول 5 ريال ما توفي منها. Because packaging is one. But am I only going to pay for your packaging? This is excellent. But بعض الناس يقول لك حبي شل كرتونة كيكتك هي كيكة هذي.
Long experience.
والله لا بس packaging صح. Packaging is one of the things I'm gonna say. So hold it, huh?
Ingredients.
Excellent. What? Tell me.
The quality. Especially
yeah. How can I tell people the quality?
Saudi
is not something that we hit on a lot. أنا بقول لك عطني فرنسي كيكة هذي. Saudi مو زين ولا فرنسي زين. But don't hit on Saudi a lot. It's a privilege, but if the quality is well.
It depends on how you market your product.
Excellent marketing your product is one thing, but how can I add to convince you that this is a niche market product? Once you mention the ingredients, if I tell you, well, it's a gluten-free, it's an organic. الجزر اللي فيه موجود مجوب من جزر الواق الواق اللي منفوق منسحوبه باليد عن طريق قطعة قماش حرير. Okay. But once I talk about the ingredients, you're gonna convince that oh, okay, ما تسبب سمنة. تأكل 10 حبات ما تسمن. Oh wow, now you're talking. This is a niche market. This is a product that I can increase the price a little bit. لأنه في something different. في something for this niche market. But imagine أنت تقول it's a gluten free. تدخلك واحدة معها gluten حساسية من gluten and she asks you, هل موجود في المنتج الفلاني as an ingredient? تقول ها. أنا ما أعرف هذا المنتج. You will lose your market. You're talking to people that have gluten problems and you don't understand anything about gluten. Remember once I talked about Rose Rise's customer? Those customers are very sensitive. بس لما تروح محل هزاز وريالين and you buy a product that breaks after 5 minutes. شاري 20 صحن ب 6 ريال. ماني زعلان إذا اتكسر 4. وأنا طالع من المحل وانكسر 4 مازن. لأنه my expectation is very low. And I went to a cost leader. So the customer is not sensitive once you go to a cost leader, but he's very sensitive once you go to a niche market. So be careful if you want to target the high range, the high volume, the high margin, your customers will be very sensitive. Talking about the abayas, والله ممكن نوع التطريز, نوع الخيوط, talking about thawb. Okay, Lomar gives you the thawb for 1,000 riyal. Okay, ايش فرقك يا Lomar? عشان حطيت لي حديده هنا لا هي توكس اباوت ذا قماش انه اتس ديفرنت اعطيك عليها ضمان 2 ييرز يو كان كم ريبير يور ثوب اوكي ناو يو توكين عشان كذا كان ممكن 1000 ريال ما راح ادفع 200 عند الخياط اللي جنب بيتي سو هي از تراينج تو كونفينس يو مور وذ ريل ثينجز نوت اونلي اند ذن هي داز ذا باكينج بارت هي رابس ات اب ان ا جود واي سو ليتس توك اباوت ذا كونتنت وات دو اي نيد تو بوت ان ماي تشيك ليست تو راب ات اب We know my market now. I said I wanna. I have been sitting on my. I felt the movement. I just need to give me the movement. So now I know my market. Each one of you now, خلاص, knows the product. He knows the pain, and he knows his market, where he's gonna play. He knows his capability. I'm gonna go for niche or product differentiation or cost leader. We need to make sure of your checklist. I like to follow the checklist of the 7 P's. Did you hear about the 7 P's? Only the people
well,
come on.
Yes.
I've added three more. Now they're 16, 17, but what I like is 7. Do you know about the 7 P's, guys? This is your checklist if you want to open a business. Number one is your product. What is your product? Okay, so we said, how can I know my product? How can I know my product or service? The pain. We started with it. أنا ما أشوف البين حق المجتمع اللي عندي. I know what is my product or service. خلاص بديت في البين now, so I know my product now. Where is the place? That's the second pain. Where am I gonna sell? Amazon, online, physical place. Okay, where is the place? What's the right place for me? If I'm going on a cost leader, I cannot open a shop for Aliya. ما ينفع. And this is where I talked about my friend Faisal. He opened a chocolate shop في شارع 30, which was the market of the chocolate shops. The shop from outside was the Rolls-Royce. قصب غرناطة وأسود برا ومذهبة وأعمدة رخام. So the place was wow. Once you enter, the kilo is, if you know, يعني most of you, I don't know, maybe the guys, you buy chocolates or not. The kilo عنده 160 ريال, 160 ريال, which is comparably very cheap, يعني, in the chocolate market. The average now is 400, 500 ريال for the good quality products. So from outside, هو يعني روبرتو كافالي. From outside is was well. Once you enter and you ask, how much is your kilo? He said 160 riyal. 160 riyal, most of the females, which was their, his clients, يفشل. أنا عارف إن الناس بكرة تجي الكيلو 160. It's embarrassing. أنا عندي wedding ولا عندي كذا جايبك من محلك اللي people, all everyone knows. This was his client and he did not understand his client. This price, minus the quality, quality number one, or quality, يتناسب مع 160. اعتقاد انه بيخلي الشريحة الأكبر. ولكن من برا لبس المحل روز رويس, لبس المحل هيلتون, ولما تدخل غرف, اوكي, ما بيقول براند عبدالله, روحتين ومساعد. اوكي, شقق مساعد مفروش. فتنصدم من برا انت جايب شيء ومن داخل شيء. فصاروا العميلات اللي يبغون شيء رخيص يجون من برا, كله هذا الشكل حرام من برا كذا, ما دخلوا الى no one will enter, بس من برا الشكل طردهم, الشكل قال لنا هذا شكل غالي ما ندخل. سو عندي على المحل اللي بعده رخام وادري ايش كذا اللي بعده. والعميلات اللي يجذبهم هذا الشيء اللي يبغون هيلتون, أول ما ينزلون يتخرون يقولون this is not the price we want. إحنا نبغى شوكليت من البلد الفلاني وبالسعر الفلاني. فهذا اللي صار فيه صار مثل ما صار فيه إيكاروس, لا صرت هنا ولا هنا. سكر البزنس, خسرت 9 مليون. كان عنده مصنع شوكليت, 9 مليون. كان عنده مصنع شوكليت, كان عنده محلين شوكليت كلها نفس الليفل. فخسر خسارة جدا كبيرة وكانت مؤلمة جدا له. وبعدها حرم يدخل عالم البزنس. لأنه كانت بداية عنده وين. This is the thing I don't want you to face and to understand. This is why we are here, to share a little bit of our pains. يعني تعلموا على رأسنا يعني. شوي غلطنا كثير. And we're still making mistakes still today. فهذه الفكرة اللي أنت لازم تنتبه لها. And once you talk to a certain market, be careful that the whole packaging fits and the location fits. So if you want to be cheap, ما تروح على شارع زي 30. أو ما تروح على الشارع زي العلية العام إيجار مليون مليون ونص. how can I make it feasible if this is done. So number one, product, place. Number three is the promotion. Promotion is not only social media. Social media is small part of the publicity that you do, making people know about your product. But there are times which 99% of what happens in social media is wrong. The person that you brought to talk about your product does not fit the criteria that you want. So if I'm going to talk about selling a Rolex, am I going to bring Fehan? With all respect to Fehan. But this is not his target audience. Fehan has a, you know, all the kids now and all that. So this is not his target audience, although he has 3 million riyal, 3 million followers or 4 million followers, I don't know. But this is not the right person. So we do now, a better thing is calling, go to micro-influencers. If I know Sarah has only 10,000 followers, 5,000 followers, 2,000 followers, but Sarah talks about gluten-free cakes every day. It's her passion. It's way more cheaper for me to go to Sarah and say, Sarah, this is a gluten-free cupcake, try it, okay, and we're going to supply it for one month. Sarah will get so excited that a company yani, respected me, and I'm very micro, and she will post about your cake maybe 3 times, 4 times a day because you respected her as a micro-influencer, and this is the new game, guys. People do not believe influencers anymore. So go to micro-influencers, go to people that has the specialism. They talk about something deeply from their heart, you believe them more. So if I'm going to talk about medicine, I'm going to come to Doctora, although she has 2,000 followers. ما راح أروح لفلانة اللي عندها 10,000 أو 20 أو 40 أو 100 because this is not their specialism. إذا هي تكلمت, I may get 60 or 70 sales من فلانة, I'll get only 10 or 30. So part of making it smarter and saving your money is target your micro-influencers. Know them very well, understand them very well, and approach them. They're very friendly. And they will be happy that you respected them. So this is another tool of doing publicity very smartly and hijacking. We call it news hijacking. What they do now wrongly is wallah infijar fil anbar. Allah yahfazhom wa iyyahom. تلقى واحد كاتب عسل وسكر طب انفجار الناس رايحة وناس يعني مصايب ومشاكل وانت داخل تبيع منتج ف he thinks انه لانه الهاشتاج عالي he can hijack it but you can do it in a smart way you can do it in a smart way اليوم والله مباراة فريقين I can hijack the news واسوي بوست كويس واشارك في البوست ما يتناسب مع المباراة بشكل creative and you get Followers, if you remember, يعني هذه قصص يمكن قديمة شوي حوش عبد الله السبيل وغيرها مع فيتنس تايم بالآخر كان في نيوز جاكينج شركات دخلت على هاشتاجات طريقة مرة ذكية وتفاعلت مع الهاشتاج and you, we knew them after this hashtag they did not pay a single ريال بس إنه عرفوا كيف يصمم بوست حلو and he hijacked the hashtag for himself or the news for himself so try to Utilize those hashtags which matches your company or your product. This is number three. Number four, we said price. We said place, sorry. Product, place, and promotion. Price. You need to be very careful doing pricing. Who's your best يعني, person to put your price? من أحسن واحد يسوي لك price. مين؟ شكراً سامة تدخين تقول لي أنت
لا لا I'm talking about شكراً
I'm talking about generally where can you get your price? Customer لسه ما عندك
customer
My competitor أبا بيع شاورما اليوم كم متوسط سعر الشاورما في السوق So I know that the range is 5 ريال 4 ريال 6 ريال This is the range So always know your competitor If, can I move from my competitor? Yes, if you can convince him and know you are a product differentiator. أنت ما أنت هوندا، أنت ما أنت سيارة صينية، أنت مرسيدس، أنت بي إم. But convince him. Or I'm a niche market. So if you want to move from the price, convince me as we said in the cupcake. أنا organic, أنا gluten free, أنا كذا. But you can now, if I came to your cake 13 وأنت بخمسة. اوكي بس انا بلوتين فري انا اورجانيك انا ما في شغل انا اوكي جاستيفايز ما اقدر اقارن بينك فاحنا نسميها الغاء المقارنه اخليك ما تقدر تقارني خلاص ف فلما نلقى المقارنة أقدر أحط السعر الأول. This is the beauty of being a differentiator or a niche market. I kill the comparison. والله براتك 10,000 ليش؟ وزميلك جار أخذ 5. أنا عندي 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 عندي تسجيل سفرانية عندي الدورة الفلانية عندي كذا عندي كذا عندي كذا. فلما يجي يفاوضني حتى في even I'm talking about personal brand. He could not compare لأن أنا a differentiated person. أنا مو بس graduate from جامعة الفيصل. أنا عندي 1, 2 لأن في 50 في 1,100 graduate. How am I different? This is being a differentiator. لا تقارني بالباتش. I have extras. We said number 4 is the price. Getting it from the competitor. A lot of pricing methodologies that works with each market. I'm talking about synergy. Why did I tell you about the triangle? Because most of the times people mistake the synergies. If I claim that I'm a product differentiator, I'm not going to write it now. 1,200,000 فقط بمليون ريال حط اكس كده على 1,200,000. This is not a price strategy for Rolls Royce. They never did it. Rolls Royce win a campaign when I was in UK. أحلى كامبين سووها Rolls Royce كانت جدا قاسية. كاتبين if you have to ask about the price, you cannot afford it. Imagine القوة وفاز بأفضل كامبين عند ملاك Rolls Royce. إنه إذا بتسأل عن السعر يقول اللي يجينا هنا ما يسأل السعر اللي يجينا هنا يكتب شيك على بياض كذا يقول تفضل ونحط السعر. فأماجن البرايسنج مثل درجة أقدر أسويها مع أقدر أسويها في العويس أقسم لا مخل طيب أقول له كم السعر أقول له ما أقدر تستخدمونه but you can't so if you understand your clients and how vulgar they are and how sometimes how rude they are and how do they want to be shown in the market. You can do this because you have a clear, crystal clear vision about your clients, and you can do this kind of pricing. And you cannot afford them if you have to ask about the price. With other products, if you are a cost leader, no. It's always 50% on wood, 20%, 30% bundle. We call it the bundle pricing. Okay. The bundle pricing, so that's another thing about pricing. So be careful of choosing. There's a 20 or 30 ways of pricing methodologies that's يعني الوقت يطول لنا فيها بس be careful you know your pricing methodology matches your strategy. Okay? Number 5 is the physical evidence. This is something where most of the people يعني miss sometimes. He has a very nice product. طبعا I'll give an example about me. Now I am Mohammed Alohaly, your consultant. Okay, your general manager or whatever you want to call me. This is me. Shmavi زي ما هو, ثوبي زي ما هو. If I did like this. ليش? If I did like this or like this. Okay? ممكن احد يطلع يطلبني برا. لو انا ما عندي برا. نفس الشماغ. شريب 120 ريال احسن كواليتي وشريب بس ما عرفت تسوي الفيزيكال ايفيدنس بشكل صحيح. Most of the time, this is where the problem happens. عندك product رائع. أدخل على Instagram حقها ألقيتكم مصورة product شباب شباب عيال هوا. طيب مصورة كيف قسم بالله شو البريات قال لي جيبي professional photographer بس يفرق معك 100%. الآن بس رفعت الشماغ كذا تغير معك perception. ليش؟ لأن small things differ. لما أقولك عطني والله you are a consultant عطني كرت والله ما عندي كرت. أعطيك رقمي شكل الكرقة كذا وكذا. ليش ما عندك business card؟ بس كتالوج على المنتج والله ما عندنا كتالوج معليش جوجل مدري وشو بيطلع لك كيكه احنا نشبه طيب ليش فيزيكال ايفيدنس اتس ا فوتو فاندي لايك هذا اليوم وتبر ات ميكس ا بيج ديفرنس ات ميكس ا بيج ديفرنس فبي كيرفل فور ذا فيزيكال ايفيدنس ايذر يور بليس اوكي اور وتبر يو غانا شو تو يور كلاينتس بي كيرفل جايز نمبر 6 is the people who is selling. كنت اشتغل مع Alexis كلام هذا 2002 قبل ما يبدأ 2002 كنت موظف مع Alexis في Alexis كانوا يشتغلون علينا مع عبد اللطيف جميل the same guy موظفين تويوتا الشرط انه يكون معاه ثانوي، موظفين لكسس لازم جامعه ومعاه لغه انجليزيه فيدخلون اختبار. Imagine the same place بس يقول لك لا انت you're talking. So the people selling لان التارجت اودينس مختلف كانوا يفرضون different شروط لل people that's gonna deliver the service. بعض المطاعم يشترطون الويتر يكون عنده شهادات معينه راتبه يوصل الى 9000 ريال ويتر. ويتر 9000 ريال يعني ممكن اكثر من راتب خريجين محاسبه بعض الاحيان. اوكي؟ لانه الويتر هذا عنده شهادات وليفل معين في تقديم الطعام في مطعم فلاني I need him. ف be careful who is the person or the people selling to whom talking to whom. احنا مطعم مره عطيب مكه كان في كمون دبان في الاكل. فنادي العمل اقول له لو سمحت في دبان قال ايش انت تفكر شرطه هنا؟ عادي تخيل هذا مدير مبيعات موجود في الشرطن ولا موجود في الهيلتون ولا نو وين هو متقبل وعادي مبسوط يقول انت مو بالشرطن عادي شيء دبان انا بس بهذه البساطه فأماجن انه you need to take care of who is the person اللي يرد على الناس. كان عندنا واحد مساعد الناس يكتب له والله ما شاء الله اكلكم لذيذ رد والله انت لذيذ يا حبيبي ما تجي يا مساعد ما ترد على الناس زي كذا فكان خفيف دمه ولطيف بس ما يصلح زعل كثير من العملاء لانه he was not the right person talking to the right people. So this is number 7 is the process. If I'm gonna claim انه انا روز وايز ولا انا بيتر كمباني ولا ذا بروسس لما ادق مو ما حد يرد لما اجي اطلب طلبيه ما توصلها في خلال 3 اسابيع لما لكن لما كنت كوست ليدر طالب انا طالب الغلاف حق جوالي طالع عليه بدولار قالوا لي التوصيل بعد 3 اسابيع ما استني بعد 3 اسابيع ما لانه بدولار لانه انا رحت على كوست ليدر فالبروسس حقي لما يكون مره صعب الاكسبكتيشن حقت العميل متدنيه لكن لما اطلب الغلاف شريته من برلوتي ولا شاريه من ديور ب 2000 و 3000 ريال يقول لي التوصيل بعد شهر لما اوصل القاه مقطوع فالبروسيس هنا ما ينفع مع هذا الكلاينت لان الكلاينت هنا مره مختلف فبي كيرفل فور ذوز 7 بيز كان يو ريمايند مي اوف ذوز 7 بيز بليز
برودكت
فيس بروموشن برايس بيزنس بيبل بروسيس. أتمنى يا رب إن استفدت وحاولت إني أعصر theory مع practices لأنه أنا أعرف دائما أنا against theories بس الثيري مو حلوة إنها تعطينا modules فلما تكلمنا عن بروكتر لما تكلمنا عن بورتر لما تكلمنا عن سيلين فيز عطتنا مديول للبراكتسز اللي سويناها فحلو إنه نجمع بين الاثنين العلم والعمل. يعطيكم العافية شكرا.
طيب أحد عنده سؤال؟ Anyone have any questions? Anyone have any questions? Just for that thinness, I think. الأمانة من أمتع المحاضرات.
إي والله.
الأمانة is like one of the, we invite everyone to speak, and this is one of the very enjoying, informative, الأمانة. So, I think because they have exams, so let's, you guys want to ask a questions, or do you want like talk one-on-one with Mr. Muhammad? What do you prefer? Actually, I was going to ask you about TikTok because one of the tweets I saw on Twitter had the issue of things about TikTok and things. So, what do you think TikTok and these apps? Do you think that's any marketing for them?
Yes, I mean TikTok now is the investment in marketing. Whether you like it or not, you love the medium or not, we always say. And this is the mistake of people designing a certain poster and put it everywhere. We call it content versus context. You have to be very careful. Each media has its own way. ما أجي أصمم poster على تويتر ونفس اللي نازل في فيسبوك ونفس اللي نازل في إنستغرام ونفس اللي حتى في سناب حقهم مصورين نفس التغريدة وحاطينها. This is wrong. Each medium has their own way of talking. So be careful. You have to design. And talking about TikTok is the next medium booming in sales. People are getting more professional, specialized. بس اللي حبيت أنبه عليه to be more wider. لا تصممون تصميم واحد ولا one language لكل منصاتكم. The same tone into Rolls-Royce, into Toyota, into whatever. Have your same tone. Have the same persona as we call it. But be flexible with the medium itself. هنا الناس تبغى صور أكثر، لا هنا الناس تبغى شوي ميوزك أكثر، لا هنا الناس تبغى فورمال أكثر. فبي يعني context versus content. Okay.
I have a question. Of course, I'm coming from a completely different background, and on a personal level, I feel I'm so far away from business and marketing. So I decided to break the ice and just study more of this session. But I always suffer on a personal level from having a short half life for any business. I feel that there's a lot of enthusiasm to open a business and to give it a lot of. A lot of stamina going on initially, but I feel that so many businesses they don't have the energy to keep going with the same quality and level.
Yeah.
And I always say how can they need to do a better job of doing that.
I mean, sure. Talking about internationally, 87% of the businesses close before 5 years. 87 international. In Saudi Arabia, it reached 90-something, okay? We are not far from the markets. So that's something normal. But why is it normal? Because of most of the people, as you mentioned. They don't know how to enter the market. It's just me and my sister, or me and my brother, or me and my friend. We saw someone making money. And immediately, I think his story is capable to be my story. Always, guys, in anything in life, start with understanding yourself. I did a shawarma business with Yazid al-Rashki. I didn't do it myself. Now, I'm the same guy, I'm the same founder. If you tell me now, do it yourself, I'm not going to do it. I can't. Shawarma business is so condensed. And I went to a product differentiator strategy. I had an open check from Yazid al-Rashki. I don't have this open check as my own money. Although I'm the same guy. But once I have a true understanding to myself, I cannot do it alone because I don't have this resource. So this is a thing to don't copy. Oh well, we saw 500,000 with this and that. Okay, 500,000, give me the money that this guy has and the publicity that this guy has and the 1, 2, 3. Okay, if you have all this, let's talk now. We're comparing egg to egg. How much do you have? Well, I give me dinner. Okay, his budget was 200,000,000. So keep comparing the story, 200,000,000. You can't. جيب لي أحد زيك 200,000 و200,000 ونقول له this is the role model for you. We can learn from 500,000. We can learn from Shawarma Plus. We can learn. But we're not gonna copy and say ليش فتح 45 فرع في سنة. Okay. أنا فتحت الآن صار لي 6 سنين فاتح كوبي شوب ما أقدر تفتح الثاني. لأنه العائد على الاستثمار من كوبي شوب. It's formula. And you take a little bit from you to you. Will to your pocket money. This simple mathematics. Going to your point is we copy. We see people successful and we go and try to copy them without understanding ourselves and what is the true or the truth behind their story. That's number one. Number two, anything in your life, feel here for at Hamas. Grab it, guys. For at Hamas, have you not? Please grab it, write it, document it, احبسها. طيب, and do something immediately with it. بعدين كمل نفسك بالنواقص. أنا دكتور, ما أعرف محاسبة, ما أعرف أسوق, ما أعرف كذا, ما إذا أكمل نفسي بالتيم اللي يكملني. عشان أنا أبيع لهم الحماس هذا والفورة, ممكن أقدم them finance, بس I don't know marketing, I don't know operation, I don't know accounting. So immediately, I have the right formula. Continue with me to have a successful business. Not only about the product. McDonald's, مرة وهذه ودي حلوة إن تسمعوها. كنا في challenge مع رئيس تنفيذي McDonald's. قالوا ممكن cook a better burger than me. من يقدر يسوي برجر أعلى من برجر McDonald's؟ من يقدر؟ برجر McDonald's. برجر McDonald's مو واو يعني. Yeah, I know that 80% of you eats in other burger places. But McDonald's, he said, طبعاً كده challenge كده نص القاعة رفعوا يدهم. We can cook a better burger than you. كلهم كانوا business owners. We can cook a better burger than you. Why don't I see your names in the market? نزل قدام يستحق. Because I don't do good burger. I don't do excellence burger. I do good burger. But I do excellent operation, and I do excellent operation. And this is what makes me happy. It's not about the product only. He said, I have a good gun. Not bad. Joanne took the tackle. My fries took the tackle. I do excellent operation. 6 minutes from coming in to going out. McDonald's and them jam, McDonald's and them cheese, my kitchen smarter than man. How it in a time or top of a jam burger, I got lost. Kitchen smarter, tell the fact you go prepare 7 burgers now. Tell the upshot, go to cut my hook for bed. For the operation, I shan't tenjah, either end of team, put a network. And I give you the operation. If you want to have a successful business, you need to have a manual operation. But you go to prepare 7 burgers now. But go to the farah fadi. ليش أبرر 7 برجرز؟ لأنه بعد 8 مينتس لو ذبيتها بزبالة تكرم أنا ينخصم عليه. هو يقول يسوي 7 برجرز. أنا ينخصم عليه لأنه بزبالة تكرم. لأنه أي ويست يدخل الموضوع. فتقول له أبشر سوي 7 برجرز. تلتفت تعدين 10 تلتفتين على 7 برجرز. كيف؟ كيف؟ ماثماتكس. كيف هو الطقس؟ مباريات اليوم ومن أقرب جامعة. وكم عدد سكان الحي؟ وكم عدد السيارات اللي تمر كل ساعة؟ ماثماتكس إحصاءات يجمعون أرقام يخليك يعني فعلاً تذهل إنه كيف ماكدونالدز شغال بهذا الليفل؟ كيف ماكدونالدز ناجح في كل العالم؟ إنه ما فعلياً أقول لك حتى وزن أنا وزن سلة البطاطس تسوون بعض المطاعم يشيل الكيس ويسوي كيف؟ طب إذا زدت وزن السلة القلي بدل ما 3 دقائق معناته حاطين تايم القلي بدل ما 3 دقائق بصير 3 دقائق ونص لأنه في ثلج زيادة نزل. اوكي فيخرب البطاطس اولدو انت معطيهم 3 دقائق از مانوال ماكدونالدز يقول لك حبيبي ما تفكر وزن السله تدخل السله تضغط البطن تشوتها كذا ينزل فرايز طب موزون عشان once you press 3 minutes 3 minutes لان هذا الوزن حقك مو انت تكب ما في الا عميل واحد حطيت شويه بطاطس تحط 3 minutes احترق وفينا عمر واجد حطيت زياده عن السله 3 minutes احترق اولدو في مانوال في 3 minutes but this would help you if you have a proper operation. Okay, people continuing you in the operational side, not only the project, you will be successful. Always focus on operation.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Mr. Mohammed is here. And by the way, Mr. Mohammed helping students to start their business. Actually, like I'm just like, so please come if you want to talk to him one on one.